In this problem, we're given a velocity time graph for a cart traveling on a horizontal track, and we're also given the mass of the cart. And our task here is to compute the net horizontal force on the cart. So here's the plan. We know we can compute the acceleration of the cart by looking at the slope of the velocity time graph. Then once we have the acceleration, we'll apply Newton's second law to get to that net force. So to compute the slope, we can think about the rise over run between any two points on the graph. And we notice the graph is passing through several integer points. So I chose the point 3,3 over here and 6,5 over here. This means the cart is moving at 3 meters per second when t is equal to 3 seconds, and then it speeds up to 5 meters per second at t equals 6 seconds. So we want to compute the change in velocity and the change in time between these two points. And our change in velocity is 2 meters per second between these two points on the graph, while our change in time is 3 seconds. This means that our acceleration, again given by the rise over the run here, or delta v over delta t, is given by 2 meters per second divided by 3 seconds. So we can just keep this as a fraction for now and call it 2/3 meters per second squared. So now we apply Newton's second law, which says that F net, so the net force experienced by this cart, is equal to the mass multiplied by the acceleration. And F net is actually what we're looking for. All we have to do is plug in the mass of the cart, and that's 2 kilograms, and then multiply by the acceleration, which is 2/3 meters per second squared. So in exact form, our answer here is 4/3 kilogram meters per second squared. But if I round to our traditional 3 significant figures, I can say this is approximately 1.33 kilogram meters per second squared, but a kilogram meter per second squared, that's a Newton. So there's our net force on the cart, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.